required by Almighty God.
That the evidence I shall give before this committee.
That the evidence I shall give before this committee.
Touching the matter in issue.
Touching the matter in issue.
Shall be the truth.
Shall be the truth.
The whole truth.
The whole truth.
And nothing but the truth.
And nothing but the truth.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Mr. John and Peter Amewu, 32. In your absence, I apologize for the late start. So let me repeat to you that we profusely apologize for making you wait 4 hours plus before starting with this vetting. So we'll make it as quick as possible. But please also assist us by being concise and precise with your answers. If you leave any loose ends, people will ask for precision. So please assist us so we can move faster.
Very important portfolio of natural lands and natural resources. What will you do to improve land and forestry administration and management in Ghana?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, if this House grants me the nod and approve me as a minister for the sector, I'll immediately set up a team to take an inventory of all the land that are within the jurisdiction of this ministry. Mr. Chairman, you agree with me that through the powers of eminent domain granted government, government over the period had managed to acquire sizable acreages of land across this country. In some instances, compensations of those lands have been paid. In some instances, compensations have not fully been paid. Mr. Chairman, as I speak today, we do not have a complete inventory of the lands within the various, you know, commissions. Mr. Chairman, it is surprising that compensation for lands that have been paid are not even known, as I've stated earlier on. And so on assumption of office, I will make sure that I take due diligence to make sure that a complete inventory of this exercise is done. That will enable me, Mr. Chairman, to know where the lands are, which ones compensations have been paid for, and which ones have not been paid for.
Can the Honorable Nominee tell us, in your own estimation, the total forest cover today, I mean to date, and what will you do to reclaim the lost forest coverage? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, the total land space in Ghana, it's about 238,000 kilometers squared, out of which about 11,000 covered the water bodies, and about 227,000 is a net. Out of that 227,000, 16% of that constitute the forest reserve. But as I speak, over 50% of that proportions have been depleted. And so, Mr. Chairman, in terms of figures, I'll not be able to give you the exact figures, but about 50% of the 16,000 kilometers squared has already been depleted. And so that is why we stand as a country. Mr. Chairman, the extent of degradation, depletion of our forests is becoming a very, very critical issue for this country. And we as a country need to do something immediately. Mr. Chairman, on assumption of office, I'm going to collaborate, if I'm given the nod by this August House, I'm going to collaborate with the chiefs, opinion leaders, and all stakeholders to make sure that those areas that depletions have been detected to be of intense, we will do replanting to make sure that we revert the current rate of degradation of our land, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, our water bodies are managed by, in fact, but now because of the realignment of the ministries, it will be managed by the Ministry of Sanitation and Water. And the mining also falls under your jurisdiction. But you realize that through Galamsey, they destroy a lot of our water bodies. What are you going to do to collaborate effectively with the Ministry of Sanitation and Water so that we can control or manage this problem?
Mr. Chairman, the issue of Galamsey is again another technical issue that is affecting this country. Galamsey today, employed over 1 million Ghanaians, direct factory hands. Mr. Chairman, in 1985, between 85 and 88, Galamsey constitutes just about 2% of the gold output in Ghana. As I speak today, it's about 27-28%. Its contribution in terms of GDP, the hidden economy, is huge. And it has employed a lot of, youth, both direct and indirect. Mr. Chairman, we will need to enhance and harness this system of operations of the small scale, some aspect of it popularly called the Galamsey, into this country. I will tackle that pillars on three or four main pillars. Mr. Chairman, I will do that through the policy, the law, technology, and enforcement. Mr. Chairman, let me use this opportunity to give credence to the NDC administration for passing amendment mining and minerals law 2015. Mr. Chairman, what that law seeks to do is to introduce stiffer punishment. And as a country, we must begin to enforce some of these laws. And so if the House give me the nod, I'm not going to take it lightly at all. If you go, Mr. Chairman, if you refuse to do the right thing, the law will get you. And I am going to apply the law to address the Galamsey issue in Ghana, Mr. Chairman.
Even if it is your party executives that are engaged in the Galamsey, are you sure you're going to be able to enforce them strictly?
Mr. Chairman, that is a very good question. Mr. Chairman, I'm not a minister for party executives. Mr. Chairman, I'm a minister for the Republic of Ghana. And for the purpose of intergenerational equity, we must leave something down for our generation to come and see. Mr. Chairman, if the past 50 years, our forefathers have done what we are doing today, I don't think we will have a water to drink. And so irrespective of your party color, irrespective of who owns the land, irrespective of your family background, the law would be applied. I think that is the main reason why the law was amended.
Will you make a distinction between Ghanaians involved legitimately and lawfully in small-scale mining, as opposed to the legal prohibition of foreigners in small-scale mining?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Yes, directly, that is what I would do. There are Ghanaians that are doing the right thing. Not all the small-scale miners are doing illegal mining, not at all. And that is why I mentioned their contribution. Mr. Chairman, those that are doing the right thing, we will need to help them. And so through training, we should be able to assist them to do the right thing. The recalcitrant one, of course, they will be facing the law. In that new amendment law, the penalty ranges have been increased between 30,000 and 300,000 above for foreigners. And so these are deterring. And if a recalcitrant person decided to go and mine in an area not designated for that, of course, that law must be applied. And so the application of the law will be done as in accordance, with the terms of the law.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, the nominee is alleged to, after the elections, have called to say that the former President Lawrence helped MPP in Volta region to maximize votes. Mr. Chairman, I want to find out from the nominee how former President Lawrence helped the MPP to maximize votes in Volta region, and the level of relationship that exists between yourself and the former President Lawrence.
Chairman, I think that relationships are personal relationships, so please ask another question.
We can rephrase the question. You are reported to have indicated somewhere that you called former President Rawlings in the course of the campaign. Is it true?
Mr. Chairman, not called. I think I've been misquoted, and I just want to leave it at that.
Do you regret what was attributed to you?
Mr. Chairman, because of the way the word called him or he called, that was not the statement I made.
Which one was attributed to you? At least something related to him was attributed to you. What was it?
What was attributed was that he did call. I never said he called me, Mr. Chairman.
Do you regret it?
Mr. Chairman, I want to leave it at that.
No, you know he's a person of high standing, and once his name is mentioned, we should say things about him that are true and things about him that we know. It will not be fair to his person and his standing that he would be associated in activities. He's a founder of our great party, the NDC, and therefore, when you associate those comments with him, you may be lowering his standing in the eyes of many people. Do you share that?
Mr. Chairman, I take measures to apologize to him.
Mr. Chairman, with your permission, I will have to revisit the President Rawlings matter. On the 21st of December, President Rawlings issued a statement on the statements that you made on the 20th of December on Joy FM. And in the statement, President Rawlings wrote, quote, "To make such untruthful and absurd claims of a follow-up telephone call, which can easily be verified, is foolhardy, imprudent, unbecoming of a political actor who is supposed to lead with integrity, and absolutely disrespectful to former President Rawlings," unquote. The statement further demanded a retraction and an apology from you. In your answer to the Honorable Minority Leader, you said you will now consider an apology. This statement was issued on the 21st of December. May I ask, what are you waiting for before you put out a retraction and an apology to the former president?
Mr. Chairman, processes is on course to render that apology to him.
The Land Administration Project, LAP, we have been at it for a while now. We are in phase two. My information is that phase two, which cost this country about $55 million, will be ending in March this year. And there are still major, major challenges with land administration in Ghana. In the absence of donor funding, continuous donor funding, how do you intend to champion a phase three, a possible phase three of land administration to address all the bottlenecks with land administration in Ghana?
The project, Mr. Chairman, the land administration project is about 25, 30 years project, an ongoing project. Lab 2, it's completed, as rightly been put by the Honorable Member. The rationale for that project is to address some of the lapses that we have currently within the system. For instance, the introduction of the GELIS, which is the Ghana Enterprise Land Information System, which seems to migrate our processes of registering land from the manual environment to the digital system. That is working perfectly. The other thing was the introduction of the client access unit, which serves as an interface between those who are submitting their papers and to those who are working on it. The good thing about it is that it's a very good project, and if funding is made available, we should be able to resolve all this problem within the land administration in Ghana.
Are you worried that key players such as members of the Lands Commission, whose mandate is wisely guaranteed by Article 2641 of our constitution, are being terminated? In one particular case, we've had a situation where even a termination letter was sent to the CEO only for a reinstatement letter to be sent again the following day. Now, are you worried that this practice is going on? Terminations, you know. I suspect perhaps it's as a result of the suggestion under Section 14 of the Transition Act. But are you worried about these terminations and the lawfulness of these terminations, especially because of Article 2641? And if you are, what will you be doing about it when you are eventually passed as minister by this Honorable House?
Mr. Chairman, I'm not worried about the termination. The current Transition Act made provisions for some terminations. And so if terminations for various agencies are effected, I presume it's done in accordance with the Transition Act.
The title of your ministry is Lands and Natural Resources. I don't know if you have been wondering, as I have been wondering, what our natural resources are and whether you really have any control over our natural resources. I'm referring here to cocoa, to timber, to gas. I see the management of some of these natural resources very, you know, out of the remit of the lands and natural resources. In that breath, will you not then say that the name has outlived its relevance?
Well, Mr. Chairman, thank you for that contribution. I would rather see natural resources more of in-situ. You know, the oil and gas, the minerals resources, the forest resources. These are the fish in the waters. These are resources that are given to us by nature. Our cocoa plantation most often comes out as a result of human activity. So resources that emanate from natural causes, they are the resources that I would describe as natural resources. I agree with you when you mention oil and gas. But even the oil and gas immediately is extracted from its natural base, it's no longer a natural resource because it has gone through some processing. The gas processing plants will process the natural gas. And I can't therefore describe that as a natural resource. It becomes, you know, a human, you know, element. So the natural resources are those that naturally are given by God.
Page 91 of the NPP manifesto states that Ghana will become water stressed by 2015. And I want to just bring you back home. We are all from the same area and town. What will you do to help us to ensure that River Dine regains its freshness, flows freely, so that all of us will have access to good potable water?
As the Honorable Member rightly put it, in accordance with our manifesto and the president's agenda for this country, making sure that our natural resources and our water bodies are kept clean for the purpose of intergenerational equity, we will be introducing a mass tree planting exercise. The MPP government, Mr. Chairman, has done it before under the mass cocoa spraying exercise. We will introduce something similar along that line to make sure that communities through which these river bodies flow or passes through, we will be able to protect them at least 50 meters from the center of the water bed and make sure nobody has a direct access to those rivers. Mr. Chairman, I am from Howe, as the Honorable Member rightly put it. River Dine is dying, and my fear is that within the next 10 years, if we do not do anything as citizens of this country, our future generations will blame us. And so tree planting is one way to address this chronic activity going within the country.
Honorable nominee, but you recall that during the electioneering campaign, the then flag bearer of the New Patriotic Party, now President of the Republic of Ghana, His Excellency Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, made an emphatic statement that if, by the grace of God, he wins elections and the MPP comes to power as government, illegal mining galamsey will be regularized in this country. Are you aware of this?
Mr. Chairman, regularization of illegal mining is a subject I am considering myself as part of the President's, His Excellency Nana Akufo-Addo's agenda. Regularization simply means we got to bring them to the formal sector and the right way of doing things. Currently, Mr. Chairman, the illegal miners just go doing haphazard digging. In my language, they say, Matra and Makwe. You dig here to see whether you find gold, and tomorrow you go and dig another place. That cannot continue. At least government need to invest some minimum amount for the purpose of explorations and prospecting. And so that if these minerals deposits are identified, we can bring them collectively under one umbrella to mine. So His Excellency the President, Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, is trying to see how we can migrate this process into a formal process. So that is exactly what I would do as a minister designate if I become approved by this house.
So when you said you were not going to condone an illegality, is that position not different from regularizing an illegal activity now?
Not at all, Mr. Chairman. There is going to be an ongoing process to regularize the system. I have mentioned earlier on, Mr. Chairman, the recalcitrant one who faced the law. There are thousands of small-scale miners there up in this country, Mr. Chairman, that are doing the right thing. You visit their mine sites, and their mine site as more perfect than the large-scale miners. We should improve or encourage those small-scale to continue. And that's exactly what His President, His Excellency, Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo is talking about.
Chairman, let me congratulate the nominee Minister Designate for Lands and Forestry. There is a matter of public interest. The conversion of forest reserve where you grant leases for mining purposes. What will be your position on this matter in order to preserve our forest resources? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Allowing our forest reserve, Mr. Chairman, for purpose of mining has its own implication. Currently, Mr. Chairman, most of our wildlife are migrating away from those forests as a result of the mining activity. The Convention of the International Trade in Endangered Species, which Ghana have signed to, it's something we need to observe. And one way we can observe this is to make sure that we maintain some of these forests to protect and preserve the wildlife. I, as an individual, and also a member of the New Patriotic Party, believe strongly that a policy direction of allowing some proportions of the forest for mining should not be entertained.
Chairman. There is Ashanti Regional Chairman of the MPP, Chairman Wontumi, I hope I got the name right, who is also engaged in some business and claims that part of his activities within the lands and forestry sector was burned down, to which he is pursuing
honorable,
some
honorable
action.
Honorable ranking member, I'll disallow this question. He's asking related to somebody who is not here. If you frame a general question, I'll ask him, but the specific to the regional chairman, who is not here. Our rules or the 67 does not permit that. Thank you.
Chairman, you didn't even allow me to ask my question.
If you reframe it,
there was destruction of the chairman's properties, assets relative to this sector. Can you guarantee that no person will suffer any consequence for partisan reasons in ensuring that every Ghanaian has a right to the benefit of the mineral and mining rights of this country?
Every Ghanaian has the right to the mineral resources through the legal regime. It's unfortunate the incident you just spoke about. We will make sure that the process of mining, either through the small scale or by the approved system of the large scale companies, are done in a very transparent, coherent, and sustainable manner. And so that will not give credence to illegality.
I know Chairman didn't allow it, but I'll give you another opportunity. President Rawlings expects a public apology from you. The public, you are intimidating me. Chairman, he expects, because strongly as I sit here, I work for the Republic and the state, but I'm mindful, just like you, that you are representative of the new patriotic party. Your comments might have lowered his standing. Will you render that apology now?
That qualified apology to His Excellency President Jerry John Rawlings.
Chairman, I'm done. Congratulations.